How hard is it to make a film like this?
Well, it's extraordinarily difficult. I began thinking of this film in 99. I started developing it in 2003 and started working on it full time in 2004. So from 2004 to 2010, I was just making the film. And a lot of that
Does making the film include the getting the money for
yes,
the
yes. yes, yes. The first 2 years were a lot of fundraising, and constantly throughout the rest of the process was also fundraising, writing grants, and also as a nonprofit getting donations, tax deductible donations that helped make the film. So you have to be a fundraiser and a PR agent, and as well as a filmmaker and a researcher. I spent months in the archives outside of Moscow looking for the sort of Soviet era footage. And what was also important to me was the 8mm home movies, which are a completely other view of life behind the Iron Curtain, this kind of intimate everyday life. And I, of course, was incredibly lucky that I wound up getting home movies of the actual people in the film, which is something I had never expected. I thought I would have home movies of people who were more or less their age group. But I was very lucky that Borja Meyerson's father was a very dedicated home movie maker and followed his son around and went into the classroom. So we have all of the people in the film as children.
And how hard was it to convince them to open up? You said you met the couple first and then to their friends. What was the key to getting them to tell you their life story, and especially some that you know, haven't had things work out the way they wanted to?
You know, it really wasn't difficult at all, and I think partly it's because I lived in Russia from 91 to 99. I speak fluent Russian. I wasn't an outsider coming with a camera crew and a translator and sticking a microphone in their face asking me to tell me about their very strange, unusual experiences. I think from all of them in their own way connected with me in that I understood a lot of their life. I had been a student. I went to film school in Moscow, so I had certainly shared the student experiences of living there. And with each of them, they were all very open, and I don't know that any of them were desperate to tell their story. There are films that are out there where the subjects of the film are very they need the filmmaker to help them spread their word or tell their story.
Was you going to them to say, please tell me your story.
Exactly. But wonderfully, they all agreed, and they liked the idea of the film. And I think one thing that worked to the advantage was that 20 years have passed. This year, it's the 20th anniversary of the collapse of the Soviet Union. And in the very busy pace of ordinary life, of daily life, there isn't that much time to sit back and reflect on the past 20 years or on your life as it is. And I think that one thing along the way is that they each found kind of welcome opportunity to sit and reflect.
And I know you're spending your time now, as this is released around the country and the world, still working on this film. But
yes.
Do you have plans for something else, an idea for a next one?
I do, but it's still early on. I'll be working on my Perestroika and distribution for quite a while. And we have our PBS broadcast coming up as well.
All right. Robin Hessman, thanks again.
Thank you.